The first of 10 competitors now moving onto the stage. This will be Lee Priest, who will make his entrance. And originally from Australia, now living in Venice, California, of course, one of the centers of bodybuilding in America. And Lee Priest letting the suspense build here.
Virtually invulnerable.
The danger, of course, of walking in so slowly and so dramatically is that if you can't follow it up, you know, it will cost you a lot of points.
Oh my.
The judges then will be kind of upset.
My name is
Khalil. This drama. And he cannot, you know, follow up with it.
You are the only survivor of the planet.
So he's under a lot of pressure right now.
Even though you've been raised.
And an unusual choice of a musical background.
You have great powers. Only some of which you have as yet discovered.
See that breathing of the stomach that you see now? The stomach moving in and out? That can cost you points. It's an absolute no-no. Because you got to show to the judges that you're in shape enough. He has not spent too much energy on pumping up before he goes out there, and now he doesn't have the energy to pull it off.
Lee Priest, 217 pounds, stacked on a 5'4" frame.
Lee Priest is extraordinary, and he's known in the bodybuilding world that he's one of those guys that has managed to be one of the shorter bodybuilders, but still keep a tremendous symmetry and proportion, which is very hard to do.
Is there a prejudice among the judges against the shorter competitor? Would you be better off if your genetics have you 6'1" to start with?
Well, I think it is better, but that does not mean that a shorter guy cannot win, because we've seen Franco Colombo, my friend, who has won Mr. Olympia twice and has won Mr. Universe 3 times, and he was only 5'5". So I think that if you have the muscles to show in the definition, you can pull it off. And he, of course, Lee Priest, can show here that he has a tremendous amount of musculature. And so hopefully with the posing, you can pull it off.
Well, now